the athletes meeting at the moment.
With all of the pros, Patty Boidle, fitness world champ, she is. All the other girls. Rachel Dillon over there, bikini world champion.
Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I know it's been a while in between vlogs, but I promise I'm going to get better with them. So I put out the topic earlier this week about my next vlog, which will be this one. And the topic of today is all about bikini comps. And so I know so many of you have many questions, and I tried to get through a fair few of them in today's vlog, but I think that maybe I'll run a little bit of a series on these just so I can cover a few more because there is so much information that I can give to you about fitness comps. So I've prepared a little bit of a list from the questions that you guys have given me. I couldn't really go into the ones that were in a lot of detail about like diet and training, because when it comes to comp prep, it is really individual and no two girls should be prepping the same, because all our bodies are different. We react to different training, we react to different diet methods. So it's really hard to give advice on that, but I've sort of tried to keep the questions today broad. So I hope that you guys enjoy this. So I guess to kick it off, I would thought I'd give you some information about myself and my history with competing. So I did my first comp in 2015, and so with that show, it was the federation was with IMBA, and it was in, I think it was April 2015. So with that show, I competed in fitness model category. So it was, the categories with IMBA were like bikini, fitness, and then figure. So I was in fitness model. And so I went down to Melbourne for this show and competed at one of the expos, and it was such a great first experience. I ended up winning, and then I went on to win overall fitness model champion. So I was really, really happy given that it was my first time. So then my second show was also with IMBA, and it was only, I think, about a month after that one. This was in Sydney, and I competed again in fitness model, and I didn't even place at this show. So it was really hard. I went from winning and being overall fitness model champion to then my next show not even placing. So that just goes to show that not all fitness comps will go your way, but it sort of just sparked a little bit of fire inside of me, and I was really determined to come back to my next show bigger and better. So I've done two shows with IMBA, and then my next show was in October of that year. So I took about 4 months of an off season, and I've really just focused on bringing up my weak points, which are always going to be my lower body. So working really hard on my glutes, my hamstrings, and my quads, just to bring them up. I don't find it too hard to build upper body muscle. but lower body is another story. So with my next show, I really, really wanted to do WBFF. I'd seen so much about it in social media, and I really loved that it would combine my passion for not only fitness, but it does have that fashion and beauty side as well, because you are judged on your entire package. So on the fashion side, on the beauty, just on your marketability, everything combined is how you present yourself is the overall package. So I started prepping for WBFF Gold Coast. So that was to be in October. So with that show, I did Bikini Diva Tall, and I placed third in that show. So I was really, really happy with that, given it was my first time with the WBFF. And again, that sparked the little bit of fire inside of me that I did want to come back and I really wanted to win my pro card. So with the WBFF, if you win, you can become a pro. A pro card is awarded if they feel that you are at that level. So my next show after that was going to be the May WBFF show on the Gold Coast. So again, a few months in between the shows to really work on bringing up my weaknesses and working on the feedback that I got from that last show. So WBFF Bikini Diva Tall in May. So this was 2016 and that is the show that I won and I was awarded my pro card. So yeah, that was such an incredible experience, incredible feeling. And I knew that all the hard work that I had put in had paid off. And then the most recent show that I've done was actually in November. So November 2016. And that was my first international show. So my first international time competing. And so I went over and did the WBFF European Pro-Am show. So I was in the Pro Bikini Diva and it was an amazing lineup of girls. And it was just such an incredible experience being able to go overseas and compete. Yeah, I'm really looking forward to my next show and going over for Worlds, which is in London again. Back to the European show. So I actually won this one. And again, it was such an amazing feeling because I had put in a lot of hard work, again, working on my weak points and just, yeah, I push myself every single day. And to know that when you step on stage looking the absolute best that you can, it's all worth the sacrifices and worth, yeah, all of those, all the time that you spent in the gym, all of those meals that you had to prep, all of those hours, it really, really is such a good feeling to know that the hard work pays off. So yeah, that's my history with competing. So I've done 5 shows in total across the last 2 years. And my next show that I'm planning to do is WBFF Worlds in August this year. So I'm really looking forward to that. So that's a little bit about me and my history. So I'll get on to some of the questions that you guys wanted to know. So one of the first ones was, what made me get started in fitness comps? So I've always been really healthy and active growing up. I've led a really sporty life, played a lot of sports, netball, athletics, touch football growing up. So I did have that sort of sportive and competitive nature about me. I started to get into the gym quite a few years ago now, and so I trained really hard, and then I guess I was just looking for that next challenge. As I became more and more sort of involved in social media, and I used to scroll my newsfeed all the time and see fitness girls flashing up and on the comp days, and I really just thought, like, I want to do that. I want to be one of those girls. They look so fit, but they look so glamorous as well up on stage. So that was sort of how I got into it. I just did a lot of research and I found a good coach, and this, I guess, was, sorry, that was my phone, I did a lot of research, and then so I got a coach. This was at the time when I was pretty unhealthy, to be honest. I was uneducated, so I was really running myself into the ground with overtraining, and I was severely under eating. So those might know a little bit with my background about that. So I guess for me, competing and getting a coach was going to be a way for me to further educate myself, because at the time I was ruining my body. So with comps, it is a fantastic way to learn about more about nutrition, more about training, and more about your body. And I guess for me, this was, yeah, it was great to really, it restored my relationship with food, because I learned a lot more about food. I learned a lot more about the types of food that you should be eating to fuel your body, to fuel your workouts, and then to like build muscle. And so I guess the fact that I wanted a challenge and the fact that I wanted to learn more about nutrition and training was what really, and also to be one of those girls up on stage, was really my driving factors for wanting to compete. Next question. what is my approach with diet during comp prep? Again, this is something that is quite individual, so not everyone is going to do what I do. I have a blended approach with macros and clean eating. So my coach sets all of my macros for me, so I know my protein, carbs, and fats, so total calories that I will be consuming each day. And then I have quite a structured meal plan based on these macros. So it's all sort of mapped out around my training session. So I have a lot of carbs pre and post, and then my other meals are more so protein and fats. So it is quite structured during my preps, which is fine. I like it, it works, it makes it easy to stick to, and I know that I am hitting my targets each day. Someone had asked what my favorite meals to eat during a comp prep. They don't really change to the meals that I eat during my off season. I eat all the time quite a lot of nutrient dense, fresh whole foods. During my off season, I might just have a few more like treats here and there, a few more cheat meals, and just a bit more flexible. So the foods that I eat don't really change during my off season and then when I am in comp prep. So next question is, how do you stay motivated during your comp prep? So this is really, this is a good question, because a lot of people, it is quite a long time that people do prep for. Sometimes it could be 12 weeks, it could be 24 weeks, it could be even longer. So it is essentially a really long time to stay motivated. I guess what you need to really ask yourself and to establish from day one is, why are you doing this? Like, why are you wanting to compete? Why are you wanting to commit to this? Because it is a long process, and it's not something that, it's not easy. It's not something that just everyone can do. There are so many ups and downs. It is quite an emotional roller coaster, but it is all part of it. And for me, I always look at my motivation, and that is myself and my progress, and that I want to be the very best that I can be on comp day. So I have to think, say, if I go off my plan, if I eat some junk food, if I do things that I'm not meant to do on my prep, is this really going to lead me to getting the best result possible come show day? It's not going to. So I, at the beginning of my prep, day one, I make a commitment to myself that I'm going to do all that I can to be the best that I can be on comp day. So that really is my motivation. So my motivation comes from within, and yeah, I guess this is something that you have to find for yourself. Why, what are your driving factors for competing, and use that and remind yourself of this every single day. Whenever you're having a tough time, think to yourself, why am I doing this? And yeah, you'll find a way to push through it. What costs do you have to factor in? So I'm not gonna lie, competing can be quite expensive. There are a lot of different things that you need to factor in. So when you are, if you're a first time competitor, you need to consider that it might, yeah, it might be costly to you. So you need to look at things like, if you're gonna hire a coach, their costs. If the event isn't in your hometown, you might have to travel. So this could be flights, accommodation. There's a federation fees, so you'll have to pay a small fee when you're joining the federation, and then even to register in the comp. Then you have to consider things like your bikini, your, if you're doing WBFF, you also have a theme wear, or you could have an evening gown if you're doing bikini. And then you've got shoes, you've got stage jewelry, you've got to pay for hair, for makeup, for stage tanning. Yeah, so there's sort of the cost that you're going to have to incur. So it is not a cheap sport, but again, it's, yeah, it's all part of it, and it is an amazing experience. How do you juggle everything with comp life? So this was asked by someone who had a full-time job and was finding it hard to, their first time competing and already finding it a little bit hard to fit in comp prep and normal life that obviously has to go on. So For me, I can relate this back to when I was working in my full-time corporate job. So I used to work in an office. I was a HR coordinator. So this was before I went full-time in the fitness industry. And this is when I did my first two preps, was during this time. So it is hard to juggle. And because, as I said, your normal life has to go on. You can't just drop everything for your comp prep. So what you need to do is just find a way that works for you to fit in everything that you need to. And so when it comes to your meals, I prepped all of my meals. So on Sundays, I would prep out pretty much all of my meals for the week. I would freeze some, so towards the end of the week, the meals weren't as nice, but that's just how I could organize and that's just how I could get it done. So it was a little bit hard, I must admit, being in an office and having to eat at all of these random times, because I was eating probably 5 to 6 meals a day. So quite a lot of those meals would have to been while I was in the office. But my work was really fine. I just ate at my desk. And you do get sort of a few weird looks when you're eating like your fish in your plastic container on your desk. But at some random time, like 11 a.m., it's not even lunchtime. So I guess it's just all part of it. And people around you that know what you're doing will understand. And if they don't, then that's fine. You're doing it for you. In terms of training, I know it can be hard if you're stuck in office from, like, you leave to work at 8, you know, get back till 6 p.m. It's just about finding a time to fit your training into your schedule. It doesn't matter if you train in the morning or in the evening, it's just finding what works for you. So I used to actually train on my lunch break. My work allowed me to take a little bit extra, so I had just about an hour and a half for my lunch, and means like I sort of started a little bit earlier, but I would race to the gym, which was really close, during my lunch break, quickly smash out a session. And so my sessions were always really time efficient. I would time my rest breaks and make sure that I was getting in there and just getting it done, put my headphones in, don't talk to anyone. So it's about finding what works for you. If you need to wake up a little bit earlier to head to the gym before work, then that's just what you need to do. Another thing that someone had asked is, how do I deal with other people's opinions of you doing a prep, the judgments that come with it, which could be from people that are, I guess, lacking in knowledge about fitness comps, or just, yeah, quite naive to the world of competing. So yeah, it is hard at times when you are, I think, especially when it comes to like social events and people around you just not understanding like why you might have to miss something, because why you can't go out and you can't eat certain things that they are. And I guess it just comes down to explaining why you're doing this and what it means to you. And the people that matter to you are going to really understand this and see how determined and how passionate you are about what your main goal is. So they should support you. And if they don't, then there's nothing that you can do. You've done your best to, I guess, let them see why you're doing this, and so that's up to them. But don't be scared to still go out to restaurants and maybe change your meal. Or there are so many times that I took my plastic container out just so I could still be social, so I could still catch with my friends, and it just sort of became a bit of a laugh that I'd come out and bring my plastic container of dinner and they'd all be ordering pizza or something amazing. So what is the best advice I can give for a first time competitor? So I think, as I was saying to you before, when you're first time competing, you really need to find a purpose and find your motivation so that you can commit to your prep 100%. There is no point in doing your comp if you aren't 100% fully there, because you want your first show to be the start of an amazing journey. You might want to continue doing these comps. So you want to really get up there and feel amazing. So if you're not ready to give 100%, then it might not be the right time for you. You need to be in the right headspace, because it's challenging. Prep is tough. There's, as I was saying, there's so many ups and downs that you experience, and it's all part of it. But if you are not 100%, if you're too busy with other things, if you mentally just aren't ready to commit to this, then it probably isn't the right time. So make sure that you are wholeheartedly into your prep, that you're going to give it your all, and just really trust the process. A lot of times you'll be freaking out, I'm not gonna lie, you'll freak out, you're like, how am I gonna be ready for my show in 4 weeks time? I don't even look like I'm gonna be up on stage. And you know what, these thoughts are gonna run through your head all the time. But the thing is, you've just gotta trust that your body will do its thing. If you are compliant with your diet and your training, and you're just giving it 100%, then it just happens. Your body works its magic, and come show day, it will all come together. So really just trust the process, commit and trust the process. So that's my biggest advice. What is the best advice just before stepping on stage? So for me, I am quite a shy and nervous person. So being on stage in front of all of these people is not something I find easy. I always freak out. No matter how many times I've been doing a comp, I still am equally as nervous each time. But the thing is, once you step out there, it is just so much fun, and you just get really in the moment, and your nerves sort of leave you, and you just have fun, you be yourself, and you just go out there and do your thing. You have worked hard to show off this body. So when you step out there, I guess there is no other feeling to describe it, but your nerves really just leave you. So my biggest advice is, even if you are nervous, don't worry. It happens to everyone. I'm a WBFF pro, and I still am absolutely shaking before I go on. But I absolutely love being on stage, and it's like, yeah, your nerves just go and you feel amazing up there. And I think that the best thing to do is, if you are nervous, is just to really practice with your posing. Before my shows, for weeks and weeks leading up to it, I would practice. I would wear my heels around the house so I feel a little bit more confident in them. And I would also highly recommend you girls, when it comes to posing, to film yourself. Don't always pose in front of mirrors, because at the end of the day, on comp day, you're not going to be posing up on stage in front of a mirror. So I think that it would be really beneficial to set up your camera, go into a gym in one of like the studio rooms, set up your camera, and just constantly film yourself running through your poses, and then you'll be able to see what your body looks like, what looks good, what doesn't, and you can change things according to that. So yeah, make sure that you are practicing, because then you become more confident, and the more confident you are, then the better off you'll be come show day. How do I deal with post-comp struggles? This is a really, really good question, because I know a lot of people, I actually find post-comp a lot harder than my actual comp prep. And I think that this is a really good question that I can delve in more, into more depth in another vlog potentially. So I will go into it briefly now. In relation to post-comp, so it's actually referred to sometimes as like post-comp blues that you can get. So at this time, it is really important to practice self-love and to know that the comp physique is not something that is achievable year-round. And it is hard, because every day you're constantly waking up, you're checking your abs, and you are getting better and better each day the closer it comes to comp. But then once your comp is over, it is hard, because you are obviously unable to maintain that comp day condition. So mentally, it's tough. We're hard on ourselves. So I think the best way is to sort of mentally prepare yourself ahead and know that it's not going to be easy post-comp, and that there are sort of a few things that you need to be aware of, and there are things in place that can help you to have a successful post-comp transition. And so I'll just quickly run through these now with you, and these are some things that have really helped me. So I guess, as I said, number one is just to mentally prepare yourself for the emotions that you'll experience post-comp. Know that yeah, you aren't going to be looking the way you do all the time. So don't expect to. I also think it's really important to have a post-comp plan in place. So my coach will always give me what my diet will be like pretty much straight after my comp, so that I know that I've got to still basically, it's called reverse dieting. You slowly introduce calories back into your diet, and you can slowly to do decrease cardio or the frequency and volume of your training. So a reverse diet plan is really, really important to make sure that your hormones and your metabolism are looked after, because competing can put quite a stress on your body. So you need to make sure that that you are looking after yourself and you're putting your health as number one priority. It is hard, as I said, with the goal not being there anymore, to maintain self-control, but just know that you cannot simply go out and eat thousands and thousands and thousands of calories of junk food. Your body, your metabolism just is not ready for it, and that's where people can have what's called a post-comp blowout, when there isn't that self-control there, and you do put on weight very quickly if you are not careful, because your hormones and your metabolism are just not balanced. After your show, I recommend having a couple of days off your diet before starting your reverse diet plan, just to indulge a little, because you have probably been quite restricted during your prep. So if you sort of get out all those little cravings, you've been craving a donut your entire prep, go eat it. If you're craving pizza, and that's the meal that you're craving to have after you've been prepping for the last 3 months, go and eat it. Get out all those little cravings, but just know, give yourself like 2 days off, and just know from that next day you're gonna really, really try hard to stick to your reverse diet plan. Also, I guess one of my biggest things that helps me is I don't just set goals around fat loss and how I look. I set goals for strength. So to have a goal like to increase your squat or increase your deadlift, this can really help you not just focus on how you look coming out of comp, but I guess also your strength and your performance in the gym. So even though you're eating a little bit more, use that fuel to perform better in the gym. So set yourself strength goals that aren't so focused on aesthetic goals. I guess there are days where you're not going to feel good post-comp. There are days where you're going to feel great. It's just, as I said, all a part of the journey. And I definitely want to speak a little bit more about this topic, but that will have to wait, because this has probably been a long one and I don't want to bore you guys too much. So I'm going to do a part two to the comp prep side of things. So if you do have any questions that I can help with, drop a comment in the box below, because I'd love to hear your feedback. I'm going to try and do more vlogs. I know that I'm not good with them, so I hope you guys like this and you found it beneficial, just to get a bit more of an insight into my life competing and a few other questions that people had asked. But in the meantime, I will continue working on putting together some more questions and bringing you guys some more vlogs. So thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I will see you all soon.